celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Hal Abrams and Judy Francis.
And your dream team's here. Toll free, 1-866-405-8405. That number connects you to Dr. Debbie, our veterinarian. Vladi, the world-famous Russian dog wizard. Joey Volani, the dog father. Animal communicator Joy Turner. And Ernie Rodina. And if this is your first weekend listening, first time you've heard Animal Radio, welcome. Grab your pet. Come on around the radio. Give us a call. We don't censor anything here. We're pretty transparent. And you'll find out in just a minute with Vladi, the world-famous Russian dog wizard. He holds back nothing. And our news director here, Stacy Cohn. Hey, if she comes showing up at your door, don't answer it. She's like 60 minutes showing up at your... When she's on a news story, she will get to...
Stop until she gets the answer.
What are you working on?
You know, a few weeks ago, we talked about cloning your dog. Somebody paid $50,000 to get their dog cloned.
Yeah.
Now, somebody's doing cosmetic surgery for their dog.
Oh.
Seriously, they do this. A dog, they paid $16,000 just to give it a tummy tuck.
Whoa.
I'll tell you about it coming up on Animal Radio News.
And I understand that Dr. Debbie wants to talk about plastic surgery that she did this last week. A vaginal tuck. Vaginoplasty? This is for real, ladies and gentlemen.
Right? On a dog.
On a... Joey Volani was on a dog. She doesn't ever practice. She can't practice human medicine. Joey Volani, what are you going to be talking about?
Brushes, combs, and rakes. Oh, boy.
And we'll be continuing our season of the stars. Our season of the stars has thus far included Betty White, Billy Dean, Margaret Cho, Elaine Boozler, Frankie Avalon, and Davy Jones.
The late, great Davy.
Still to come on the season of stars, Eddie Money, Dr. Joyce Brothers, Kevin Costner, Carrie Ann Inaba today. She was a judge on Dancing with the Stars.
She is a judge.
Is a judge? Okay. And also Cory Joyce. He's a NASCAR driver. Two in one day. Wow. It's pretty good. Also, Prince...
Lorenzo Borghese?
Lorenzo Borghese.
Borghese. The parents have a big line of cosmetics along with his dog line. Real big.
He'll be coming up in just a couple of weeks along with the singer from the Marshall Tucker Band, David Gray. Is that correct?
Doug Gray.
I knew it was a D, one of those D words. Who do you want to hear on Animal Radio? What celebrities love their animals so much you want to hear them on Animal Radio? Give us a call, 1-866-405-8405. You can also tweet us. At Animal Radio. We're over at Facebook at Animal Radio. And, of course, every single day this week, we are still giving away big prize packages for liking us, trying to get those numbers up. The consultant says, you gotta raise those Facebook numbers.
Yeah, two or three is not cutting it.
We have 500,000 listeners every week on 101 stations across the country and XM Satellite Radio. But the Facebook account not looking so good is what he says.
Come on, everybody.
And I don't want to be pounding pavement, so help us out. Go ahead and like us, and we'll pick one person that likes us every single day this week, and we'll give out this prize package, which includes stuff for your pets as well as you. And that's over at facebook.com/animalradio. Of course, all that information over at our website at animalradio.com. A bevy of information, and if you miss any part of today's show, you can find that over at animalradio.com. We have a podcast of this show. I didn't even know what a podcast was until last week. Frankly, I didn't know what Facebook was until a couple of months ago. Apparently, they taped a show. I thought they had to burn the tapes of this show afterwards, but they taped the show, and then they put it up on the internet for people that miss any part of it, and they're calling that a podcast.
I thought it was like Mission Impossible.
And I just learned what a podcast is right now.
Because I told you, right?
Right.
Ernie answers the horse questions around here. Joey Volani, we picked him up from Animal Planet and from the show Groomer Has It. I think that I'd end up with my kneecaps broken if we didn't hire him. But
if you didn't say that,
yeah,
you know, the best judge and all that.
But he answers our grooming questions here at Animal Radio. Of course, Vladi, the world-famous Russian dog wizard, in the green room right now as he prepares. Before he comes on the air, he actually does this little exercise, and he drinks what he says is tea, but I don't think it's tea. I think there's something. He puts packets of stuff in it and bottles of stuff in it, and he says it's necessary before he answers any questions. This guy does not censor anything. So let's hear from you right now, 1-866-405-8405. I'm getting the signal right now from Judy Francis, our producer.
Giving you the eye, the evil eye.
She's swinging her finger around. If she does it horizontally, it means hurry up. If she does it vertically, it means you're crazy in the head. And she's sort of doing both right now.
So you're crazy and hurry up.
We're heading to the phones next for your calls.
Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Al Abrams and Judy Francis.
And welcome, my friend. It is toll-free, 1-866-405-8405. Toll-free to Dr. Debbie. She's our veterinarian here answering your vet medical questions. Or Vladdy, the world-famous Russian dog wizard, answering your dog questions. Or groomer Joey Volani, our dog father, who will tell you how to groom your dog so they look spectacular, just like Ladybug, the studio stunt dog. Animal communicator Joy Turner, and our horse expert Ernie Rodina. And Dr. Debbie in the green room right now, working her way in here. She has some information about a client that came in this week who got into their hookah, and apparently some of the tobacco in the hookah. And, yeah, I don't know if they're talking about pot or just tobacco, but we'll find out. She also did an interesting surgery this week. She did a vaginal tuck. It's a plastic surgery. Yeah, it is.
Can we say it on the air?
I just said it on the air.
You used the bad word.
Let me add, Vlade, do we ever hide anything? Is there anything we don't say on the air?
You're right. We'll always say something, not what the people would love to hear, but what they need to hear.
That's the way we work here at Animal Radio.
They need to hear about that vaginal tuck.
I want to know about it. I don't know about you. I didn't know that animals got plastic surgery like that.
Mika, close your ears, please. I'm just
don't want Mika to hear this. Yeah. By the way, if you're a brand new listener, we want to welcome radio station KFWB in Los Angeles. If this is your first time listening, you know, we've been around 11 years. We welcome you with open arms to the conversation. It is toll-free. As we continue our season of stars today, we have NASCAR driver Cory Joyce joining us, as well as a judge from Dancing with the Stars, Carrie and Inaba. Sure it's not Inaba?
No, it's Inaba.
It's Inaba. Is that right, Joey?
That's right. I watch it.
You're a judge.
I watch it. Yes, I'm a Dancing with the Stars guy. You know, I can't help.
And we have Stacey Cohn. She's our news director here, and she's working hard in the newsroom. What's going on?
You know, it's always hard to pick the name that you want for your dog, but they've done some research, and the names you like and the kind of dog that you like seem to go hand in hand. And if you love the idea of a dog named Jethro, well, that'll say a lot about the breed of dog that you want. I hear the Beverly Hillbillies in the background. I'll tell you more about this coming up on Animal Radio News.
Let's hit the phones. 1-866-405-8405. Hi, Leonore. Welcome to the show.
Hi. How are you?
Good. I understand you want to talk to Vladdy, the world-famous Russian dog wizard.
Why are we laughing? It doesn't sound good.
Russian dog wizard. Is that your dog?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, I have these two puppies. One's 1 year old, the other one's two. And I've tried so many things. They keep chewing on my wood under my bed. And
okay, tell me what you're trying.
We have a bowel movement. The wood's in their stool.
Okay.
My
dear, let me take in charge the situation. Because I'm talking to the thousands people. And met thousands of people by doing this dog training for 30 years in 5 countries around the world. You know, for me to help you, it's like you're asking brain surgeon to put the shot in the dog's butt. It's so simple. Dr. Debbie, why are you laughing?
Okay. Well, I've tried everything. I bought everything.
Okay, hold on. You like talk too much. Hold on 1 second. Let me ask you questions. Question number one, just very concrete. What dogs you have? What breeds? What age?
Okay, my 2-year-old, she's a Chihuahua and Poodle, and the 1-year-old is Pomeranian and Pekingese.
Okay, breeds which is known for being problem. So tell me, please, what is your main concern? Is just in one sentence. How can I stop my dogs from chewing what?
Yes. What else can I put on the wood so they don't chew on it?
Hell, translate me, please. Where she's putting Dr. Debbie.
She's saying the dogs go under the bed, they chew on the wood in her house, and then the wood goes through them and comes out in their stool. They're chewing up wood in the house.
They're eating it. So I'm wondering, what can I give them to help them stop that?
Well, but what this bed came about? Why she's referring to the bed?
They go under the bed and chew on the wood.
Okay, so that's it. Just, you know, we're 5 minutes trying to figure out one simple question. Okay, so the dog goes under the bed, find the, some type of the wood under that, and the chewing it. And the caller asking, what can I do to stop it? And my answer will be simple. Address the symptoms and address the cause and do two things at the same time. Number one, the simple solutions, just put the boxes under the bed and don't allow the dog go under the bed. Number one.
Yeah, I tried covering it in different ways, but they find a way to get in there.
Okay.
I was getting so frustrated, I was almost ready to just get rid of them, but
no, you don't need to rid of them. You just call into the right person. So number two, what I would do, I would visit your local hardware store. You don't need to buy 2x4, but you need to buy double stick tape. Or you can locate in the pet store a product by name Sticky Paws. Dogs hate, especially your little dogs, they're like a cats. They hate when somebody really gluing their paws toward the, when they lose control over their paws in nature. It's very dangerous for them to have that sensation. And okay. I would go and tape it, maybe 2, 3, 4 lines, like almost like a barricade when the Germans attack Russians. We did it around the Moscow. So I would do it all around your bed, okay? That's what I would do. Yeah, and if you don't like this method, here's what I would do. I would go on internet and basically find the product by name Screaming. It's called Screaminal Mat. It's a black piece of the mat. When the puppies step on it, it creates very squeaky, like, they hate that stuff. And what I'm going to do, I will put that Screaminal Mat next to the entrance in that bedroom. And I will bring them in. And instead of waiting when they step on it, I will put their paws on it. And as you put their paws on that mat, it's going to scream. And you say, ah, and just get them away. And after that, they will never go in that bed.
Oh, okay. That sounds like a wonderful idea.
It's called Screaminal Mat. And please email me at Vladi at, what is my email address?
Vladi at Animal Radio. It's pretty simple. Vladi at animalradio.com. And that's spelled V-L-A-D-A-E.
And I will send you a link.
Can I interject for a moment?
Sure.
I think this, wouldn't we also need to address that we have two pups that are running around the house that are bored out of their mind, that we need to offer not only something for them to do, but also to provide maybe some other type of physical barriers, crate training, getting these guys out, getting them exercise, getting them tired.
I would also give them something else.
I need to do more. The thing is, I work graveyard in the day. I take care of my aunt, but I'm trying to make time now. I take them out to the park and I walk around, and they follow me and they run around and play with the other ones. So,
Dr. Davey, I'm feeling like a psychic hotline. This is caller is looking for the quick fix to her long-term problems. She's not going to do these things. That's what I suggested her, but you are absolutely right. I totally agree with you, because that would be addressing the root cause. But my dear caller, one more thing you can do, you have to give them alternative to chew. So go to your local pet store and get the toys, which comes from 3 categories. Tell the person you want to get the chew toys, you want to have interactive toys, and you would like to get the play toys, and set up the few sets of those toys. Each of them represent those categories. I keep rotating them. Thank you for calling us.
Get those big bones too that they like to chew on. Those big humongous bones that the big dog, they love those. And let me tell you, the Pomeranian Pekingese, they're being little. He sure chews it up pretty good. It looks like a big dog got a hold of it.
Lenore, I'm going to give you Vlade's phone number, his personal home phone number, and he likes to get calls like at about 1 in the morning. That's when he feels he's at his best. So hold on for 1 second there. 1-866-405-8405 to connect with the dream team.
Can't beat
this type of the clients, it's just, I mean, I know of them. It's just, they're not going to listen, that stuff. That's just, give me the aspirin for the headache, Vlade. Just give me that aspirin. That's what they're looking for.
This is Animal Radio.
Provide your pet protection from biting pests with an easy once-a-month application. Advantage 2 quickly kills fleas within 12 hours on cats and dogs. Canine Advantage 2, for dogs only, repels and kills ticks, fleas, mosquitoes, repels biting flies, and kills lice. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantix 2 are waterproof and kill all flea life stages. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantix 2 are available at your veterinarian or favorite pet specialty retailer and are registered trademarks of Bayer.
This is Judy from Animal Radio. For months now, I've been telling you about the Stella and Chewy's dog food. Now I want to tell you about their cat food, made with 100% raw meat. And just like all Stella and Chewy's products, these dinners are made without grains, fillers, artificial preservatives, colorings, sugar, or salt. They come in four flavors: Chick Chick Chicken, Super Beefalicious, Charming Chicken and Beef, and Yummy Lickin' Salmon and Chicken. Visit their website at StellaAndChewy's.com. That's Chewy's, C-H-E-W-Y.
Phyto-Friendly is the travel and lifestyle magazine for you and your dog. Each issue includes hotel and destination reviews along with health and wellness topics, dog training tips, and the latest fashion trends. Pick up a copy at Borders, Barnes & Noble, Hastings, or go online to phytofriendly.com and subscribe today. Phyto-Friendly is the only magazine dedicated to the travel and lifestyle of man's best friend and the one magazine your dog will thank you for.
Why read a newspaper in the age of the internet? Because you take the time to think things through, like your love of animals. You want to know where your voice and donations can be most effective. Animal People is the newspaper for people who care enough about animals to give real thought to how best to help animals. Request your free sample copy at www.animalpeoplenews.org.
Hi, this is Joy Behar on Animal Radio. Please spay and neuter your pets.
This is Animal Radio, baby.
It's Animal Radio. Jimi Hendrix, big animal lover, big cat lover, a lot of cats. Not a lot of people know this, but he was always surrounded by cats and dogs, and I believe a turtle or two.
No, let's throw some hamsters and guinea pigs and some.
Where else will you learn this kind of information? Right here on Animal Radio. Is that my phone or yours? That's my phone?
I turn off my
Why do people
volume.
Actually call me when I'm on the air?
Yeah.
Okay, let's.
You're
let's,
the same person who turns your phone on when you're in the doctor's office, I bet.
Yeah, but that pisses you off. Somebody's in there taking up your time and they answer the phone and it's, you know, like their friend that they're texting. Should I answer this?
You know, what's worse is when you go to the doctor's and your doctor answers the phone.
Yeah, this is the reality of life, you know. Just pick up the phone and just tell him, so you're on Animal Radio with Vladdy, Russian dog wizard, and that's it.
Trying to do this radio show.
Yeah. Jeez, it was my proctologist telling me to come pick up my results, but I didn't want to announce that on the air.
Good thing you didn't.
Good morning, good afternoon, Pam. Whatever it is where you are, how are you doing today?
Hi, I'm just fine. Thank you for taking my call.
What's going on?
My sister adopted an 8-year-old Boston Terrier, sweetest dog, but she has an odor. After about 3 days after a bath, she has an odor again that's really, you know, smelling the house up. So we're hoping that maybe you could tell us a good remedy that would not hurt her skin or coat that she could use for her.
Okay. All right. Well, I've definitely got a lot of tips on this one. Now, the big question is that you say that after the bath, the odor goes away?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Because some of the first things we look at when we're talking about stinky odors from dogs, I look at the mouth, make sure there's no dental disease. I look at the butt, make sure those anal glands are attended to, because those have the most god-awful odor to them.
Yes, they do.
Yeah. So those things we really work at. Look at that first, and then I'll start attacking and looking at the pet as a skin, pet skin as the potential cause. You know, is the doggy itchy or scratchy? Have any patchy hair loss? Anything going on?
No, she does not. She's very healthy.
Good. Well, that's awesome. Now, one of the first things I'll do is make sure I replace the dog's collar with a brand new one. Reason is I solved a dog who had horrible skin odor. Every time after the pets was bathed, it got better, and then it started getting nasty and stinky. And some collars, if you flip them over on the backside, especially the nylon ones, you can actually get a lot of odor and kind of an oil secretion on there. So before you spend any money on anything medical, make sure you check that first. Okay. That being said, then we start looking at other things. I would talk about the food. Examine the ingredients on your bag of food. Sometimes dogs that have fish-based ingredients in their diets can have an inherent odor to their skin. So that, too, is an easy fix. If you can figure that one out, then you can move down the list there. Next from there, we start to get into some of the skin-related problems, things that might be things like seborrhea or what we term as hyperhidrosis. those are specific types of skin changes that can happen with allergies, hormone problems, some of those type of problems. There's different therapies with shampoos and topicals that we might go with different directions there. The way to figure that out is to see your vet, have them do some quick skin tests, and to see what's going on the surface of the skin. If there's not a lot going on and we don't have signs of allergies, then we kind of go and deal with more of this kind of hyperhidrosis, which is basically a lot of the apocrine sweat glands that just kind of produce this, it's not even a greasy fluid. It just sometimes feels greasy to the touch, and you won't see anything on the skin. Pets, we don't really want to overbathe, and we want to make sure we address potential underlying causes. And the number one cause of that type of problem can be underlying allergies. So, unfortunately, that too, you'd want to get to the vet so you can start looking at some remedies to deal with that and different types of shampoos, because we don't want to use degreasing shampoos. We don't want to use those type of products on a pet who has more of an allergic skin disease with hyperhidrosis. So that's very different there. Those that have more of like the orangey yellow sebum, kind of the buildup on the skin, and you can see different things adhered to the skin surface, you know, that's going to be more of maybe a seborrhea type direction, and that's going to be more degreasing shampoos, things with sulfur or salicylic acid in the shampoos. That's more appropriate for that. And then also, if the vet's taking samples from the skin, we really look for mites. We look for things like bacterial infections, and in many cases, we really got to get on therapy for those, be it an antibiotic or an antifungal tablet that can really help tackle that. Because, yeah, you will have a temporary improvement in pets that have those kind of infections, and then as soon as that bath effect wears off, then you're right back to square one. So I don't see how we'll get out of this without going to the vet, but okay. I wish I had that little microscope with me that I could kind of see through the radio, because that really, a little bit of the CSI work really goes a long way with these kind of things. And you know, Hal and Judy know that I'm like all about looking under the microscope, and smells too. I do like to diagnose things with odor.
We're working on the technology, though, that you can hold up your pet to the radio and Dr. Debbie could instantly cure them. But nothing yet. We wish you the best of luck with that, Pam. Hopefully you'll find a solution there.
Well, thank you so very much, and I will pass this all on to my sister.
Thank you very much. 1-866-405-8405 to connect with any one of the Dream Team right now. This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Stella and Chewies. Not just a fun name, but a great product. They make natural goodness food for dogs and cats, made with raw USDA-inspected meat. It's raised naturally. There's no added hormones, no fillers, no grains, no antibiotics. It's just good food. And it's the official food of Ladybug, the studio stunt dog.
She loves it.
She will betray her own mother for Stella and Chewies. So good, we'd love to give you a sample. All you have to do is send us a self-addressed stamped envelope. The address over at the website at animalradio.com, with a lot of other great things, by the way. Check out the website, get our address, send us that self-addressed stamped envelope, and we'll send you back a sample of either cat food or dog food. Please indicate whether you want cat food or dog food or both.
Thank you.
Well, that could only mean one thing. Ladies and gentlemen, please all bow for the dog father, Joey Volani. Damn proud to have him on Animal Radio with your grooming tip of the week. And what words of wisdom and inspiration do you have for us this week?
I vent a lot when I have tips, because a lot of my tips come from what happened the week before.
Yeah.
And again, I had one of these annoying women in there that was very upset with me. They were hating me.
What did she say? What did she sound like? What did she say?
She wanted to know, how come I got to shave her dog all the time every time she comes in? And I want to tell her, it's because you come in twice a year and you do nothing. Nothing but sit on the couch there, lady. And what you got to understand is we have three things that you need to know. But if she would have called into Animal Radio, she would have understood, because I could have told her this.
Sure.
And basically, you have brushes, rakes, and combs. And I'm going to go through them real quickly, okay?
Write this down.
Brushes, rakes, and combs. Because you see what I'm holding here? Well, I'm holding a comb. And this isn't a magic wand, okay? I'm a groomer, okay? And I can only work with what I have. If you want your dog to look beautiful, this is what you need. You need, for a short-haired dog, okay, that sheds, you need a rubber curry brush. You need, for a dog that has knots and tangles, you need a slicker brush. And you need, for the dog that has no knots and tangles, and you're going to maintain it every single day, you need a pin brush.
Pin?
Just slow down, slow down.
Yeah, slow down. Curry, slushy, slurry, what was that?
Slicker brush.
Slicker.
Slicker brush for knots and tangles. Okay? For no knots and tangles, pin brush. And then, Hal, then for dogs that shed, you need a short pinned rake, okay? And then you have your comb. Now, your comb is the check, okay? Because you do your brushing first, and then you go through with the comb, you check it. And then you know what happens after that, Hal? You bring your dog to me, and I make your dog look beautiful.
Now, wait a second.
Beautiful.
You're encouraging us to go ahead and start grooming our dog? Doesn't that put you out of business, or it just makes your job easier?
No, it doesn't, see, because it makes it, if you want beauty, you got to start at the home. You know, it's like the people that want to wear the bikini. Like what I'm doing right now, I need to lose the weight so I look good in the bikini, because I'm going to, or in the bathing suit, I should say, because I'm going to wear that bathing suit. Right now, if I put that bikini or that bathing suit on, I'm not attractive.
My eyes are burning.
I still,
in my head.
We will not see your bikini on there, Bailey. That's what's going to happen.
Listen, I thought I had a tip going here, guys.
Yeah,
okay?
I'm sorry about
Settle
that.
Settle down. So the bottom line is this, is you gotta do something in order for the end result to look wonderful. It's like Vlade. Vlade, you know, gives you all the tools to train your dog, but if you don't work with them at home, you got nothing, okay? So forget about it.
Forget about it.
Forget about it. So remember what I said. It's brushes, combs, and rakes.
Oh,
brushes,
my.
Okay? Brushes, combs, and rakes. Oh, my. Brushes. And you'll have a beautiful coat.
So for German Shepherd would be best what?
For a German Shepherd is a shedding dog, and I would use a short pinned rake.
Short
my
pinned
comb.
Rake for you there, Vlad.
Short pinned. How spell rake. That pin?
Pin. Is that P-I-N-N-E-D?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry, because for Russians, just asking us to spell it like asking cat to swim. Okay, I got it.
There you go.
Hey, I seen a cat do backflips last week, 2 weeks ago at the circus.
Wow, that's pretty impressive there. Is that on YouTube anywhere?
It was the best thing in the circus.
There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, the thinner and svelter Joey Volani on Animal Radio. Congratulations, by the way. He's lost 39 pounds, and I believe using Weight Watchers. Is that correct?
I'm using Weight Watchers, and if they don't become a sponsor soon, I'm not going to talk about them any longer.
Okay, what are you waiting
so
for,
Weight
Watchers?
You better get on board here.
This is a prime opportunity for you guys. 39 pounds, which is pretty good. Of course, Judy, this is 15 pounds for you?
15, and I'm just doing it with good eating healthy and exercise. I'm not using any weight programs.
Yeah. Yeah, I need to gain weight is what I need.
I know.
Yeah. Okay.
Sometimes it's, just to go back to the basics, just to eat less, exercise more, and
that's
works
it.
Better.
People think there's magic, and unless you're snorting crack cocaine, that there's no magic for this. You got to work out, and you got to eat the food.
Eat proper food.
But that never worked for me either, though, so.
Of course, I see how you're eating. You always have a double, triple size of a hamburger.
When was the last time you had a triple size
Keep
burger?
Keep it up there, Palsy. Well, me? Okay, I see where we're going with this.
Okay, let's talk to you right now, okay? 1-866-405-8405. Pick up the horn now to talk to Dr. Debbie, to Vlade, the world-famous Russian dog wizard, if you have a grooming question whatsoever, even if it's your turtle, and how to turtle wax your turtle. Dog father Joey Volani could help you. Animal communicator Joy Turner can bridge that gap. And, of course, our brand-new horse expert here at Animal Radio, Ernie Rodina. Big E.
Animal Radio is brought to you by...
New from Bayer Animal Health. Advantage 2 quickly kills fleas within 12 hours. Canine Advantage 2 for dogs only repels and kills ticks, fleas, mosquitoes, repels biting flies, and kills lice. Both products are waterproof and kill all flea life stages. Advantage 2 and Canine Advantage 2 are registered trademarks of Bayer.
This is an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Now there's a healthy and natural solution to prevent oral disease in your pet with no brushing required.
I'm Stacey Cohen for Animal Radio. Well, you can't always judge a dog by its breed, but you can often judge a breed by a dog's name. So finds a new analysis of thousands of canine companions with the data revealing some pretty specific naming patterns for different types of dogs. See if your dogs kind of match up to this. The research offers the first evidence that it's not just your imagination, that there are a lot of Rottweilers named Rocky. poodles named Coco and Shih Tzus named Gizmo. The names you like and the kind of dog you like, they seem to inform each other, says Laura Wattenberg. She's a naming expert. So if you love the idea of a dog named Jethro, it says a lot about the breed of dog that you want. Wattenberg, best known as an authority on baby naming trends, she's got a website and she went through all these animal shelters and high-end breeders alike and compiled a list of about 5,000 dog names and photos. Though a number of common themes emerged, she found the type of name chosen was frequently dependent on the breed. Human names, they seem to be rising across the board. I actually have two dogs, Jack and Mary, that have human names, but my son named those dogs. I also have Tuffy, doesn't fit any of that. The kind of name you choose probably depends on the breed and your lifestyle, says Wattenberg. Well, there's a little doubt that a UK couple loves their dog. According to the Daily Mail, Denise and David Smart have spent almost $16,000 on cosmetic surgery for their bloodhound, Junior. The Smart's pet dog suffers from a rare condition that causes excess skin to develop. I have that when I eat a lot. The folds of skin nearly caused Junior to lose his sight and prevented him from running, poor guy. So to correct the issue, the Smarts paid for operations like a tummy tuck and a facelift. Denise says Junior looks like a young man again. Wonder if he has that smush, you know, that look like, what's her name, Joan Rivers. And then she says he's got a new passion for life. Well, good for him. A Commerce Township, Michigan woman remains locked in a battle with a nemesis apparently trying to take over her yard. Edna Gaisler has to combat the same 35-pound wild turkey each day when she attempts to come outside with the bird gobbling loudly and preening in front of her. Gaisler says that while she doesn't want to call animal control, the turkey is now a constant problem.
Because he comes around 7 o'clock in the morning and stays to 7 o'clock at night.
That turkey that Geisler has dubbed Godzilla spends the night with other wild turkeys on state land behind her property, but returns the next morning to stalk Geisler all over again. Probably gets a kick out of it. I would, too. She's kind of got that voice that makes you just want to do it over and over again. That's just me, though, all right? And don't tell that turkey that Thanksgiving's on the way, because she'll probably be eating it. I'm Stacey Cohen. Get more animal breaking news at animalradio.com.
This has been an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Our pets can show signs of oral disease by age 3. Pets Life is the healthy and natural solution with no brushing required. Visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com. Did you know that 80% of dogs show signs of oral disease by age 3 and the cost to fix these issues can be up to $1,000? Now there's a healthy, natural, and affordable solution, and no brushing is required. Pets Life Oral Care breaks down the plaque and tartar that leads to gum disease and bad breath. To avoid those large vet bills and keep your pet healthy, call 888-453-4682. That's 888-453-4682. Or visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com.
It's Animal Radio, 1-866-405-8405. And we all know Greg Biffle. He's been on the Animal Radio show many times to show his support for animals.
He is one of the best NASCAR drivers that I know. But he is not the only NASCAR driver who loves those animals. We welcome to the show Cory Joyce. Welcome, Cory.
Hey, guys. How are you?
Pretty good. How you doing?
Oh, doing fine.
Now, there's another NASCAR driver who's really into his animals. How did you get so involved?
Well, I've always had a love for animals, and it's always been one of my things on the side here, but not other than racing. And I actually ended up rescuing a dog out of a homeless lady's car, and she's been with me ever since.
Not the homeless lady, the dog.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, the dog was in the car with the homeless lady. But I took her to the racetrack the first weekend I had her, and been with her ever since. I always had a love for animals and always wanted to help out the other animals that were out there, and I just want to make sure that they have homes and caring people for them other than them being out on the streets.
So this is a pit bull lab mix that you have. What's his or her name?
It's Macy.
Macy, and you bring Macy down to the track?
Yeah, she goes sometimes in the RV rides and all that stuff. So whenever we can, we try to bring her. either way, she's at the race shop or she's under the car working with me. So
does she helps you? She'll pass you tools every once in a while, perhaps?
More like lick me in the face.
Yes.
But. And she has a lot of fun sticking her head out the window when you're driving.
Yeah. Yeah.
That sounds like it would be fun.
I noticed on the front of your car you actually have a Humane Society logo. What is that all about?
Well, I just want people to know that they're still out there and make sure that people know that they can go adopt a dog any day that they want to, you know, and give these dogs a wonderful home.
Cory, hi. I'm Joy Turner, the animal communicator. And Macy has been in my head for the last probably 10 minutes.
Wow.
Just wanting to talk to you about this whole shelter thing. So if it's okay with you, I'll share with you what she had to say.
All right.
Okay, she tells me that she wants you to know that she would really like a bigger part in this whole promotion for shelter thing that you're doing because she thinks that they really deserve to have a good home. Animals is what she means, really deserve to have a good home before they go to their lifetime home. And she thinks people really often misunderstand the animals that are in shelters because not all of them are lost and feeling forlorn. Some of them use it kind of like a stepping stone to get to the person that they really want.
What kind of part would she like? Would she like to be in TV commercials? What is she looking for?
I asked her that question just now, as you asked, and she's not sure what it would look like. She thinks that Cory would be in the best position to decide how she could be what she calls the spokes dog with you, Cory.
That's something I'd like to do. I'd like to give them more towards the animals than anything else. I mean, I just want them to have a perfect life. I don't want them suffering at all or anything. I just want to help out any way possible I can.
You also have the Cory Joyce fan club. I know a lot of the racers have the fan club, but yours isn't just for racing. You're trying to raise money for the animals through your fan club?
That's right. Anything that we make, we are trying to put that towards the animals and towards anything that they can possibly need.
There are a lot of NASCAR listeners, and I know that sounds really strange for being an animal show, but in fact, one of our affiliates, the station owner, is a big NASCAR fan. What message would you like to deliver to all the NASCAR fans listening to Animal Radio today?
Well, kind of a tough one there. just basically, the message that I'm trying to relay here is animals are part of the family. I mean, we try to make them part of the family and just care for them and make sure that they're properly living and all they want to be is played with and loved. They don't want to be anything else. So basically, just support our local shelters. That's about it.
Cory, Ernie, the horse guy here. Any other animals other than your dogs are you involved with?
Basically, any animals. I mean, I have family and friends with horses, the cows, and anything on that side of family and farm animals and any animal possible that we can help. Or, I mean, I have a cat also, and my little brother has a little hamster up there. He's got him a little condo and everything, so basically anything to do with animals.
I'm trying to think if it was you or there was another NASCAR driver. I happened to be watching an episode of Turtle Man, and he went down in North Carolina, South Carolina, and got these snapping turtles out because they were bothering his animals. I don't know if you remember hearing anything about that or not.
No, I hadn't heard anything about that. That's actually interesting. I'd like to see who that was.
It was NASCAR because they actually took Turtle Man for a ride around on the car, and I thought, well, I wonder if this is Cory.
Yeah.
But obviously not.
Cory, do you ever hang out with Biffle?
He actually lives down the road. Yeah, I don't hang out with him. I've met him a couple times, but no, I haven't really hung out with him that much. I see him all the time, but
usually in the rearview mirror, hopefully.
Yeah, I mean, one day, hopefully.
Cory, thank you so much for joining us today. You're awesome for all the work.
Website?
Yeah, is there a website?
Yeah, it's CoryJoyce.com. Also, you can follow me at Twitter. Cory Joyce Racing is the username. And also, my Cory Joyce fan page is up on Facebook, and you can find me there also.
I'm going to go like it right now. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time today.
Thank you.
Take care. Have a great weekend.
Thanks, Cory. I probably blew everybody's mind on Turtle Man. You guys will wear a turtle.
I hadn't heard about that.
Have
you seen it, Joy?
I've heard of it.
Yeah, it's on there, and it's on Animal Planet.
Turtle Man.
And he actually went down to a NASCAR driver and cleaned his pond out by hand of snapping turtles.
You got to watch out for those snapping turtles. I had one as a kid? Yeah, they bite.
You should see Turtle Man, Hal.
I'm going to actually watch Animal Planet for the first time.
We need to get him on the show.
Judy, get
Turtle
Man.
Turtle Man.
Get Turtle Man on the show.
You tell Turtle Man to bring those turtles to me, and I'll turtle wax them for him, okay?
There we go.
We'll shine them right up.
That's live action.
Vinny Penn here coming at you on Animal Radio. The topic du jour, or dare I get cheeky and say a pet peeve of mine. When that friend of yours that you haven't seen in years, a girlfriend of mine, came up to me recently and said, do you want to see a pic? I showed her pictures of my kids, and she said, do you want to see a picture of my kids? And she pulls out a photograph of two dogs. I don't know that there's anything more frustrating than this. I get the sentiment of the couple who's decided against having children, but to get a dog together and regard that as, that's our child, and to regard it seriously, that's what's kind of appalling, or the people who do it, see, if you do it tongue-in-cheek, that's one thing, but to show a photograph of two Rottweilers in enormous hand-knit sweaters and say, these are our kids, Chip and Eagle, no, they're not your kids. I'm all for the treating the pet like a member of the family. I had two dogs in my lifetime, and they absolutely were members of our family. Man's best friend. I am down with all of that. But they are not your children. As a father, I take offense to it. I have two kids of my own, and it is a totally different situation. I feel ridiculous even trying to lay out why it's so silly. Now, granted, I dated a few girls in the day where I could have had children with them and they would have been dogs. I mean, I get all that. But to show that photo and say, dead serious, these are our children. We love them like you love your own children. No, you don't. No, you don't. Because my kids would never have that tartar build up on their teeth. Vinny Penn, Party Animal, Animal Radio.
Hi, I'm Dick Van Patten.
And I'm Jimmy Van Patten. We want to tell you about our new Animal Planet show called Who Let the Dogs Out?
It's on Saturday mornings, 10 a.m. Eastern, 9 a.m. Central. Check your local listings for the West Coast. It's a fun show starring Tillman, the fastest skateboarding bulldog, and Norman, the scooter dog.
They travel to interesting places in search of the most talented pet in America to join our Natural Balance sports team. If you have a talented dog
or a cat, send your video to
WhoLetTheDogsOut.tv. That's WhoLetTheDogsOut.tv.
Your pet could be famous.
You love cleaning the litter box? I didn't think so. Fortunately, with World's Best Cat Litter, problem solved. It's the only litter that uses whole kernel corn to clump quick, scoop easy, and safely eliminate nasty pet odors. And because it's made of 100% natural ingredients, World's Best Cat Litter is pet, people, and planet friendly. We offer a money-back guarantee if you aren't completely satisfied. Find it at a store near you by visiting www.worldsbestcatlitter.com/animal radio.
What dog food is specifically designed to reduce the risk of cancer, settle digestive upsets, reduce scratching and shedding? Canine caviar. What dog food reduces red tear stains and hot spots? Canine caviar. What dog food has probiotics that reduce the chance of soft stools and have a higher calorie count for better nutrient absorption? Canine caviar. So what are you feeding your dog? If you didn't answer canine caviar, visit caninecaviar.com today and get your pet started on a longer, healthier life.
It's Animal Radio. This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by World's Best Cat Litter. Ready to solve your litter box problem? Switch on over to World's Best Cat Litter. It is the only litter that uses whole kernel corn to clump quick, scoop easy, and eliminate those nasty pet odors. It's guaranteed. Or your money back. And in fact, how would you like to try your first bag on the house? Head on over to worldsbestcatlitter.com/animal radio, and you will get a rebate form on your first bag of World's Best Cat Litter, you lucky kitty.
And you'll love it.
And let's see, we have Steve on the phone for Dr. Debbie.
Hi, thanks for taking my call.
What's up?
I have a Karen Terrier. We drive a truck, so he's a truck dog. He's been great in the truck. One thing that's worrying us is he doesn't seem to want to eat, and I don't know at what point I really have to worry about it.
How old is the doggy?
8 or 9 months.
And is there any other kind of health problem going on along with that?
He's had a little bit of diarrhea, and he threw up once, but that was a couple of days ago. But he used to really like canned food when we gave it to him, and he would gobble that right up. And now he's not even eating that.
Okay. Well, I think the first thing that I would look at, if we're having digestive problems, vomiting and diarrhea on a regular basis, that may be something we want to address. Get a stool sample to the veterinarian, check this baby for parasites. We're at an opportune age with young pups where those kind of things can cause other symptoms in the body. Now, when you said a couple things kind of just jumped out and some lights went on in my head, and I don't think it was the migraine I was having, was that you said that he's a Cairn Terrier, and he's a young guy, and he's not eating well. So right. a couple of those things really make me wonder about the possibility of something called a liver shunt or a hepatic shunt. And actually, very commonly in small breeds, toy breeds of dogs, if we have a young dog that just doesn't eat well, isn't a hearty eater, just turns their nose up at food from time to time. And if there's not a lot of other symptoms, we really look at investigating these liver shunts. And basically what that is, it's a type of an abnormal vessel connection in the liver. And it can actually cause some problems where they can't detoxify their body. And some of the symptoms of that can be, you know, a little vague. We see a lower appetite. They can be a little depressed mentally, some diarrhea from time to time, behavior changes. Some doggies will be a little smaller stature than they normally should be. So I would say that would be something I would get your baby to the vet. I would typically get a stool sample, check for parasites, but we may need to do some specialized testing with some lab work to check out something like a shunt. Because believe it or not, Cairn Terriers are one of the top breeds where we can see this problem. Also see it in Malteses and Yorkshire Terriers as a very highly represented. So I think I would definitely move in that direction wouldn't play around with diets, switching things around a whole lot. I think we need to get this baby to the vet and get him checked out.
Okay, Steve, hopefully you heard that on the radio there. Get the dog to the vet, have him checked out. It looks like there may be more going on. 1-866-405-8405 to connect with our dream team. If you're brand new, welcome. To my left, Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions. Sitting right next to Dr. Debbie, Vlade, the world-famous Russian dog wizard. Dog father Joey Volani on my right, Ernie Rodina, our horse expert, and on Skype we have Joy Turner, all here to answer your questions right now. Welcome, my friend. It is Animal Radio. Celebrating our 11th year, yet this may be your first weekend joining us. I want to welcome our brand new affiliate, KFWB, AM 980 in Los Angeles. Thanks, guys. If you're listening on there, we'd love to hear from you at 1-866-405-8405. Dr. Debbie is our veterinarian here. She answers your vet medical questions. Vlade, the world-famous Russian dog wizard, answers your dog questions. Also based out of Los Angeles. He can help you, by the way. He has a three-month waiting list for his clients there, but you don't have to wait 3 months on the phone here. You only have to wait a couple of minutes if you want to speak to him. And it's free, a lot cheaper than he charges. How much do you normally charge?
One less than $265.
Oh, okay. That's not that bad. That's pretty good. You could charge more now. You know that.
Yeah, I want to keep it kind of affordable for the people because so many, and I give this special discount for the rescue organizations. In Los Angeles, for instance, I have a few referrals that famous black comedian by name Richard Pryor.
Oh, yes.
So his wife is Jennifer Pryor. She has a wonderful, it's called Jennifer Planet. It's a wonderful rescue organization. So many pets need to get adopted.
She's been on the show before.
She's an amazing person.
And I was actually in a sitcom with his daughter, was it Rain Pryor? Rain Pryor, the head of the class. Great family. Joy Turner is here. Also, Ernie Rodina answering your horse questions, and dog father Joey Volani. You've seen him from Animal Planet and Dogs 101. And he just bragged to me because last weekend, I guess they did a whole bunch of reruns of Dogs 101, and he was in each and every single one. He started texting me at 6 in the morning, turn on Animal Planet, turn on Animal Planet. We have our season of stars continuing. We have Dancing with the Stars judge Carrie Ann Inaba, following next weekend with Kat Cora, Gary Berghoff, hopefully Lyle Lovett. Ernie's working on that. Apparently they're pretty close friends. Kevin Costner, Prince
Lorenzo Borghese.
I'll never get that right. Lorenzo Garbanzo?
Borghese.
Okay, Borghese. And from the Marshall Tucker Band, Doug Gray will be joining us. And let's see, we're going to the phones now. I believe we have Sue on the phones for Vlade. Hi, Sue. Welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you.
What's going on?
I have a 5 to 6 year old purebred German Shepherd that I adopted through a rescue in Orange County. Wonderful dog. He doesn't destroy anything, doesn't dig. He's a good dog. He does have dog aggression, and recently he's shown aggression towards me.
What did he do to you?
I had worked with a trainer part-time previously. One of the things that we worked on was leave it. So in other words, put a treat on the floor, tell him to leave it. When I tell him to pick it up, he does. And this particular time, he decided, no, I'm not going to leave it. I'm just going to eat it. Tough if you don't like it. I bent over to reprimand him. He tackled me, pinned me to the floor.
Wow. You were on the floor.
Scared me to death. Yes.
But he didn't bite you, but he knocked you down.
He did not bite me. He did pin me to the floor.
Oh, my gosh. What F that trainer was smoking. Holy moly, to give you advice like this. Because he was driving in the wrong direction and in the wrong car. Sue, you cannot challenge anyone in your life, including your dog, unless you have no authority over him. Look, I know you understand or not, but I always like to use the language of examples. My clients love it. So by example, I have to tell you, in this situation, your German Shepherd dog, Scott, remind me Vladimir Putin. And you remind me famous United States Congressman John McCain. You know the John McCain, he's a great warrior, he did so many great things for this country. But sometimes goes too much overboard and, just sometimes let's bump here, bump there. And especially when it comes to the Russians, I'm not sure if probably he can forgive. So he was hit down by the Russian rocket one time in the past. So basically you did, you start to tell him like he's telling right now, unless we put pressure on Putin, unless we put pressure on Russia. Who are you going to put the pressure on? Do you understand who you're talking with? The same thing is here. Who are you going to put the pressure on that dog to challenge him this way? You can correct him and he will correct you back so quickly, so fast. Here is what I would do if I were your trainer. Number one, German Shepherd, it is not the pit bull. German Shepherd is so easy. They're such a loyal people. They don't have unpredictability as much as pit bulls or another bully breeds have. So you can easy to create social bond. How to do that? Very simply. As with the humans, Dr. Debbie, why look at me like this? You have to do three things together. Yes, Dr. Debbie, sleeping together, eating together, and working together. Here is what I would do. I would put your dog's crate or his dog bed next to your bed all the time. I would, every time I go, even pick up the milk, my dog will be with me every time, everywhere. I would stop democracy with feeding him for free. I would basically giving him food, but I'm not going to challenge him that way. I will basically put the food on the floor, regular one, but I'm going to open the canned food. My hand would be giving, not taking away. I am the good news bringer. I got to get the plastic spoon, going to approach to his food and give it to him. And he will look at you as a good person, not as a bad person. I'm going to do some obedience training with him, put the collar on leash, and the color I'm going to use for him, not the pinch color, I cannot suggest it. I would use gentle leather or halter. So if, God forbid, something happened, you will be able to close that mouth because that mouth has teeth. So it's very easy, like a horse who can control the head, can control the body. After all of that things, when you create the social bond by working, sleeping, and eating, what I mean eating together, I mean eat first and after feed him the way I ask you. When you've done everything, from that time, you can use the gentle leader gentle leader has a buckle underneath. So it's one of my big secrets, by the way, hell. I a little bit close his mouth and buckle it. so he could not use canine teeth at the worst case scenario. And after, I'm gonna hold the leash with my left hand, with the left hand, and tell him wait. And if he doesn't wait, I would guide him away from my hand, and after tell him wait again, and after tell him okay, and do it a few times, but not just stand in front of him without tools, without anything, and playing the Russian roulette. Do not play in the Russian roulette. Play in the chess. That would be my approach.
That makes sense
okay,
to me.
Okay. So thank you so much for calling us.
Well, thank you. Thank you for taking my question. I appreciate it.
Thanks for listening to Animal Radio, Sue. 1-866-405-8405. Toll free to our dream team.
Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Hal Abrams and Judy Francis.
And your dream team of experts, Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions, Vladdy the world famous Russian dog wizard with your most vexing dog issues, Joey Villani, the dog father, helping you groom your animal, animal communicator Joy Turner, bridging that gap, and our horse expert, Ernie Rodina. Toll free, 1-866-405-8405 to connect with any one of them. Our season of the stars continues, and we've had quite a season thus far. We've had Betty White, Billy Dean, Margaret Cho, Elaine Boozler, even Davy Jones before he passed. Mm-hmm. Frankie Avalon, the very much alive Frankie Avalon. And coming up in the next few weeks, we have Dr. Joyce Brothers, perhaps Lyle Lovett, Kevin Costner, Prince
Lorenzo Borghese.
Lorenzo Borghese. I just learned about him this weekend. But he's a prince, apparently. You said prince, I thought we were going to have Prince the singer on.
No.
That's what you were hitting my genre for when I was like a youngin'. I was like, all right.
Hey, I have an idea.
Well, now you'll like this one if you like old genres. From the Marshall Tucker Band, Doug Gray will be joining us in a few weeks. And today, one of the judges on Dancing with the Stars, Carrie Ann Inaba. What were you going to say, Vlad?
Yeah, I have a great idea. Let's invite next time Vladimir Putin. He's a big animal lover, and I think he will be more than happy to participate in our radio show.
Okay.
We're becoming bigger and bigger.
Once you get in touch with him, make that happen.
Set it up.
Sure, I will call to KGB people.
Yes, and have him contact. Sure. Have his people call my people.
I understand he just got another term.
Yes,
Russia.
Yes.
They're big listeners in Russia. We're number one in Russia, by the way.
Yeah, you better be, and you better be good to him, because otherwise we may never even hear about you after that.
Also on today's show, we're going to be talking a little bit of plastic surgery that Dr. Debbie's been involved with, a vaginal tuck. And we're talking about it on a dog, not herself or anything like that. This is a dog, apparently, that needed this vaginoplasty. Vaginoplasty, is that how you say it? Also a ferret who got into the hookah. And I don't know if it was pot or tobacco. We'll find out. That's all on the way right here on Animal Radio. I'm going to stick around for that. And then we have Stacy working hard in the newsroom. And as I've always said, if she shows up at your door, don't answer it. Just like 60 Minutes. What are you working on?
Do you love your pet so much that you just squeeze it and hug it so tight? Do you love it so much that, unfortunately, when it dies, you'd have it freeze-dried? Some people are doing that. I'll tell you all about it coming up on Animal Radio.
Freeze drying your animal. You know who should be freeze dried, by the way? Bob Barker. Boy, you know, he used to be I really liked this guy for a long time because he got elephants out of Alaska. He puts the end to the traveling circus animals. But damn, if he didn't make the stupidest mistake in the world, giving $2.5 million to PETA, one of the worst organizations in the world. Oh, by the way, if you're a new listener, this is how we talk all the time. We have potty mouths and we don't hold anything back here at Animal Radio. Anyway, he gave $2.5 million to PETA, an organization who has a 95% euthanasia rate. What do they spend their money on? Well, you've seen it. If you're no stranger, it's usually to something a little over the edge to bring awareness to the animals. It's usually something that doesn't really help the animals in particular. I'll get on my soapbox before the show ends. That's all right here on Animal Radio. Let's hear from you right now. Dr. Debbie answering your vet medical questions. Vladdy, the world famous Russian dog wizard. Joey Villani, the dog father. Joy Turner, our animal communicator. And Ernie Rodina. We're all waiting for your calls right now on Animal Radio.
Dogs or cats, horse or emu, animals are people too.
A
A dog owner from Myrtle Beach is spreading a safety message after her dog lost part of his tongue in a terrible paper shredder accident. Sandy Clark's boxer named Cross lost chunks of his tongue by getting it caught in a shredder in her home office. Clark said it was a terrible experience. Cross was screaming with his tongue still caught in the machine for 10 to 15 minutes until they were able to put the shredder in reverse. Clark is trying to make people aware that shredders need to be unplugged and should include a warning about the dangers to children and pets. As for Cross, his prognosis is very good. He was able to keep most of his tongue and will soon be back to eating, drinking, and licking. Just not shredders. I'm Britt Savage for Animal Radio.
Celebrating our connection with our pets. This is Animal Radio. Here are your hosts, Hal Abrams and Judy Francis.
And the numbers are toll-free here. Put those fat little fingers in the phone and dial 1-866-405-8405 to reach Dr. Debbie. She's our veterinarian answering your vet medical questions. Vladdy the world famous Russian dog wizard with your dog issues. Dog father Joey Villani, if it has anything to do with grooming, he knows about it. Animal communicator Joy Turner, or our horse expert Ernie Rodina. And this hour, our season of stars continues with Carrie Ann Inaba, and she is a judge on Dancing with the Stars. Also this hour, we'll find out about the ferret that ingested the hookah tobacco, and also about that vaginal tuck that Dr. Debbie had the privilege of working with this week. For a dog, by the way. She's strictly
I don't work on people, although I've had been that offer. People have said, won't you work on me? No.
A little cheaper to do it that way, but no, she's not licensed to do that. We have Stacy working hard in the newsroom. What are you working on?
Do you love your pet so much that you'd have it freeze-dried?
Oh, my gosh.
I'll tell you more about this. You know, a few weeks ago, we talked about cloning your dog. Now, somebody's doing cosmetic surgery for their dog.
Oh, boy.
Seriously, they do this. They paid $16,000 just to give it a tummy tuck. I'll tell you about it coming up on Animal Radio News.
By the way, coming up in the season of stars, hopefully Lyle Lovett. Ernie Rodina apparently is tight with Lovett, so we're waiting for that. Also, Prince...
Lorenzo Borghese.
Lorenzo Borghese?
Borghese.
Borghese. I want to make sure that we know how to pronounce all these celebrities' names before I get them on the air, please.
Okay.
From Marshall Tucker, the Marshall Tucker Band.
Lead singer Doug Gray.
Doug Gray joining us. And also coming up, Dr. Joyce Brothers, Eddie Money, Ed Begley Jr.
Mm-hmm.
With your Carmen Paw Print special. And Gary Berghoff, Kat Cora, and Kevin Costner.
Ooh.
All joining us. Very excited. You know, I got to say, that all the season of stars that we've had, this is perhaps the best.
Very exciting.
Seems like all the celebs are coming out for this. Let's take a phone call right now for Vlade the World Famous Russian Dog Wizard. We have Jennifer on the phones. Welcome to the show, Jennifer.
Hi. I'm so excited. Thank you so much. Vlade, I was actually at a hair salon today, and the lady doing my hair, her dog was trained by you in Michigan.
Wow. Oh, that sounds wonderful. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, high praises. Listen, I have a Bernese Mountain Dog that is about a year, and he is unwalkable on a leash. And he's bulldozing my children. He's not listening. We're literally having to drag him out of the house just to get him to go to the bathroom. We have tried several trainers, and they've just said, that your dog is just going to have to just wait till he gets older and then he'll settle down and you can walk him. But I literally cannot walk this animal.
Okay, that's not going to happen because he's not going to be better. He's going to be worse. And you need to take care of these things now or it's going to be too late. So here's the few things I would do if I were you. Number one, I would definitely start to communicate with him in Doglish, not in English. Okay. What I mean by that, don't use the word no, no, no when he does something bad. Use canine sound of disapproval. Which imitating growling. As you make that sound, clap your hands, move forward. Moving forward means invasion, personal in the personal space, that one will really gonna get his attention. And if he will not obeying you still, you have to bite him. Like its own mother would do. Its own mother would bite and lick. And after that, it's gonna be over. Nobody goes to the jail because their culture is not our culture. You know, mom says no and mom reinforces it and that's it. And you can do it by getting pinch collar. You gotta get the pinch collar with that dog because he's not gonna listen to you with anything else. And put the maybe 6-foot leash and let him hang around the house. And if he does something bad, snap him on the leash as you scream, and move forward. Now, walking. Walking is so important because if you walk him, he will not walk you. If he is not going to walk you, he is going to be very polite, obedient, and follower dog. In order to do that, all what you need to do have a slack on the pinch collar, and if a dog goes ahead of you, turn around and snap the leash. He momentarily goes a little bit ahead of you again. You turn around and snap it back before when he went ahead of you. Kind of do back and forth a few times, and do not give him $2 for speed violation because of they are very physically insensitive. And after that, I will teach him in doglish, going to the dog bed when the people come to your home. Just don't do that sit, stay. It's not going to work. And here's how I'm going to do it. You know, I would like to look at your dog right now if you could, if he's around you. And I have to look at any human. For instance, your husband. Okay. He's around. And look in their faces. Do you see any differences between your dog face and your husband's face?
No.
No.
Okay. It's the dog's cuter.
Okay. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Sorry, buddy.
Anyway, I see differences. And what's happening is your dog face is very ungulated, like a pointy, and your husband's face is flat. Because God created the dogs where the nose goes, pack goes. And all what you need to do with your body language, with your face, with your shoulder, you have to pointing where you want a dog to go. So put the dog bed and somebody knock the door. Hell, you're going to be knocked the door. Knock the door, please. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, you have to say, what is his name?
Bernie.
Say, Bernie, please, tell me.
Bernie, please.
No, it's too democratical. He will tell you, forget your mother. You have to say, Bernie, please.
Bernie, please.
That's good. And if he will not go, you grab by the leash and he flies in. Because doggy mama says one time. So here is my best possible advice. Okay. Never give any commands you cannot enforce. Always reinforce your commands. Do not repeat them. Follow with the consequences. Take any disobedience on the first command as the personal insult. And if something will not work, please give me a call and I will stop by and fix your dog's behavior problem with the speed of Russian satellite guided missile. Thank you for calling us on the Bloody Talks. Everyone is listening.
1-866-405-8405 to connect with the Dream Team. And this portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Pets Day, a unique program for guests and their four-legged friends available at the Flamingo, Bally's, and Harrah's Resorts in Las Vegas. Pet Stay includes the food, the water dish, the sleeping mat, dog treats, and even specialty room service. Find out more at caesars.com/petstaylasvegas. Head on out there tonight. If you love wine, you want to try out UNL Vino. Yes, it's a little...
Wow.
Las Vegas celebrates the 38th annual wine tasting. Take a sip for scholarship. It happens at the Grand Ballroom at Bally's Las Vegas. $75 or $100 at the door, and it goes through the 26th. So, Doctor, have you ever been to the UNL Vino?
I haven't had the pleasure. You know why? My husband makes me work on those days.
Your husband makes you work?
Yes. He schedules me for work on the UNL Vino days so I don't get overserved.
He probably will have a girlfriend that day, I can suspect.
I bet they really do a great wine tasting day.
It is. I've had friends that go there, and it is just a wild time. It's a lot of fun. Very educational, too. So,
and the money goes for a good cause.
Yes, scholarships, apparently.
There you go.
They should do that here in Central Coast.
Because everybody takes a sip, and hey, if you can get a scholarship out of it.
Take a sip for scholarship, UNL Vino. It's the Las Vegas 38th Annual Wine Tasting at the Grand Ballroom at Bally's Las Vegas tonight. Bring your animals, not to the wine tasting. They can come to the hotel room. By the way, this Pets Day program, thank you for sponsoring Animal Radio. It's available at Caesars Palace, Paris, Planet Hollywood, Harrah's, Flamingo, Bally's, Rio, the Imperial Palace, all the best right there in Las Vegas.
This is Animal Radio.
Maybe your dog can sit. Maybe he can roll over. Maybe he can even play dead. But when you tell him to stay, he's never done it like this. Caesars Palace, Paris, and Planet Hollywood Resorts in Las Vegas proudly announce pet-friendly accommodations. Our new pet stay program includes in-room accommodations for up to two dogs, food and water dishes, sleeping mat, dog treats, specialty room service menus, and more. Book your stay at caesars.com/petstaylasvegas or call 800-427-7247.
Attention, diabetics covered by Medicare.
Call now and you can be one of the first customers to receive a new pain-free talking meter at little or no cost to you. 800-917-2411. 800-917-2411. These new meters are more accurate, easier to use, and are pain-free, so you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Even better, if you're one of the first 100 callers that qualifies, you'll receive a free Betty Crocker Living with Diabetes cookbook. 800-917-2411. 800-917-2411. That's right. If you're a diabetic and you have Medicare, you may qualify to receive a new talking meter and a free Betty Crocker cookbook with your first order. But hurry, supplies are limited, so call right now. 800-917-2411. 800-917-2411.
Radio. And there is no doubt that Dr. Debbie has the most intriguing career of us all, as she you deal with a lot of animals, and this week a ferret that ingested hookah tobacco. Now, are we talking about pot or tobacco? What are we talking about here?
Well, from what I'm understanding, it was supposedly tobacco that is smoked through a hookah, one of those kind of fancy thingamajobbers there.
Like a bong. Okay.
Yeah. Although, you know, I'm kind of questioning. there was some young individuals involved, so I don't know that the parental influence really brought the truth out. I don't know.
Okay. So what happened? What happened to the animal?
Well, actually, the ferret was witnessed to get into the discarded remains from the that was in foil, that was already smoked. So after that happened, they kind of watched the ferret, and it started to act a little weird. So they rushed it right into the vet, which is great, because anytime we have a suspected toxicity with tobacco, or certainly marijuana, we need to get veterinary care right away. So this pet was starting to feel lethargic. We were able to do some supportive care, induce vomiting. And, you know, tobacco in itself, it actually can be quite dangerous, and it'll cause problems where a pet may be really wound up and excited. They may drool, vomit, have diarrhea, seizures. They can even go into a coma and die from plain old tobacco. So it's really quite, you know, dangerous. So you have to watch those cigarettes around your pets.
And cigarette butts, too.
Yeah, and you know, this, the amount that of nicotine that can be toxic, maybe for a dog or cat, anywhere between 20 to 100 milligrams of nicotine. Your average cigarette may have about 20 milligrams, but in the butt, you could still have about 5 to 7 milligrams. So if you have enough dirty butts around, you can have a problem. That sounds weird.
It does.
I work with the monkeys.
Speaking of dirty butts, you were, now, did you actually do this surgery this week, this vaginal tuck? Not hers.
Yes. Thank you.
This was actually done on a dog.
Yeah, sure did. Yeah. Okay. And it's actually, it's called a vaginoplasty, but some people know it as a vaginal tuck in, you know, in women. But basically, we did this for a doggie who had a lot of excess skin around her vaginal area, and it was kind of folding over, and when she urinated, it caused an irritation, and she was getting infections and a lot of chronic problems there. So it's a great fix for a pet who has this type of problem. So we just cut a little bit of skin, kind of like a crescent shape above it. We suture it together, and it lifts things and allows the area to dry out. So, yeah, it was a wonderful success for this baby.
Is it nice looking now?
You know, no, I'm just curious, you know, because you're supposed to, I mean, you're not a plastic surgeon, you know, and just...
Hey, Vlad, this is what I do. And you know what? There are so many dogs, female dogs, that could benefit from this. And I should have done it before and after photo. I kick myself for that because this doggy is going to be so much happier to not have chronic problems, irritation. And there are so many clients that I have, they have problems with this recurring for their female dogs. And they sound so drastic. They get freaked out when you say, I want to do a plastic surgery on their dog. But this is actually a quality of life thing. It's not something aesthetic. It's something to prevent medical problems. So
prevent the problem. But when you mentioned the first time, I was thinking you're talking about functionality. I was thinking the dog has a problem with the sex. But, you know, I see it different. Different functionality the dog has a problem with.
Yeah, no, we're not breeding dogs here. We just want to make that back end look better and also breathe better, if you will. That sounds weird.
Oh, so looks better was. Now you were laughing at me in vain. So looks better was something the people put in consideration. I understand that.
Hey, Vlad, my work, everyone says it looks wonderful. So I may not be a plastic surgeon, but I am still very good.
Your accent is almost like a groomer from New Jersey.
I think she was going
better than understand him.
I think she was going for the Russian accent there.
Yeah, I think that's, it was Russian.
Hey, listen, we get a lot of emails here because a lot of you just don't want to be humiliated on air at 1-866-405-8405. And face it, we tell it like it is, and sometimes that makes you look really bad. Sometimes it makes you look really good. But if you have questions, you can email us those questions. Also, you can Facebook them and tweet them to us. And we actually got one. This is an email. It's for Dr. Debbie. She has a boxer who has a dry, crusty nose, and sometimes it bleeds. What is it that they can do for this?
Yeah. In boxers, they are very prone to a type of condition we call idiopathic nasal hyperkeratosis.
Wow.
A lot of words there. But basically, it's really dry, crusty, and yes, it can crack and bleed. It's one of those things that happens. So we don't really know what the cause is in many of these cases. But there can be some things you can try. Bag balm or even lanolin can be applied on a daily basis to the nose. There's some other products that are used for foot problems in people. There's one called carousel that you can apply a couple times a week to the nose. It is a chronic problem. You do have to treat it chronically or it'll come right back. And then, you know, in some cases we can see problems where allergies, bacterial or fungal infections can cause this. So, you know, it is certainly worth raising that concern to your vet, making sure that not something more serious is going on.
Mm. Here's another one. This comes in for Vlade. This comes in from yourvoice@animalradio.com. That's our email to send all your questions to. Got a brand new puppy. Our older dog keeps growling at the new puppy like he's going to attack it. What should we do?
Blah, 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 blah. Next one. Because I keep telling about this all the time. People should have thinking about these things before they got the new puppy. You know, they need to make sure the dog is not aggressive to another dogs and don't expect a miracle. So they bring the new puppy and he's not going to growl and bite on that dog. And listen, people, if your dog was fine with another dog prior, you've done it. You know, your puppy has a puppy license. So up to 4 months... He is protected by the mother nature, by the law of canine culture. And if your dog still will snap that puppy, it means your dog's wire are crossed. They're not supposed to do that, you know. So sometimes the puppy, like a teenager sometimes, or little babies, or not little, I would say toddlers, they just cross the line and need to get disciplined. And the canine culture, your dog don't talk. He bite.
Huh.
So let them work it out a little bit. And if they not can't work it out, give me the personal call. Next.
Okay, this comes in from Thomas on Facebook. And by the way, you can Facebook us at Animal Radio. He's getting a new dog. He wants to know what the top three choices for dogs are that he should look at and the top three that he should stay away from.
Oh, okay. So basically, choice and the best? Yeah. Okay, I got it. Number one, I would say Labrador Retriever. That would be my best choice, and it's in the most popular in America. I think because Labs are Democrats' dogs. You know, I'm not a racist, but also color. Just be careful. Color of the lab, basically affecting their personalities. Chocolate lab normally have allergy doctor, and they dumb sometimes. And black lab just like, hey, buddy, doggy, hey, goofy. And if somebody comes with the aggressive lap, it's got to be yellow lap. Portuguese water dog, USA President Barack Obama has. Love that one. Love that one. One of my client, hockey legend, Steve Eiserman, had the same one, Lulu, which I trained to the point, was like a human. I love those breeds. And the third from the smaller one will be Maltese. Has characteristic of ladies' dogs. However, I had a lot of males clients that own that dog, and they love it. They're true joy to owe. Now, regarding my three breeds on the blacklist. Number one, Chow Chow. I have not met even one Chow that has not tried to bite me, doctor. I'm not sure about you.
I have a hole in my thigh where a Chow Chow took a bite out of it.
Wow. You know, the only one Chow Chow I loved was the one I trained as the puppy. Oh, my goodness. We had like a German-Russian fight, but after that, that Chow Chow turned out really well. People don't even think of Chow. More likely, it's a goofy-looking lab. Number two, Sharpei. Look, to be honest, doctor, and everyone who is listening to me right now, I have met a few nice Sharpeys, but mostly owned by my office manager, because I was training them, I guess. You know, she was lucky. She just have no aggressive Sharpeys in your house, but, you know, that could be a problem, too. And the third, you believe it or not, sausage dog. Dash hound, forget people about pit bulls. Sausage dogs biting Americans more than any other breeds. They just don't make headlines.
There you go. 1-866-405-8405 is the toll-free numbers. yourvoice@animalradio.com to email us. Facebook us at Animal Radio. And by the way, like I've said a million times before, like us on Facebook this week. Every day, Monday through Friday, we're giving out a big prize package for you and your animals to one person that liked us this week and next week. Also, on tweet, if you want to Twitter us, you can do that at Animal Radio. We take your questions there, of course. Vlade can't answer them in 140 characters, but we'll try to answer them on air for you.
Yeah, I have a problem with spelling sometimes because spelling for me, it's like you guys asking the cat to swim. You know, it's not my strongest point, but I can talk with a New Jersey accent, and I hopefully if you listeners understand our groomer, you can definitely understand Vladdy.
Say Joyzy.
New Jersey. He doesn't even finishing the end of the words.
Joyzy.
You know, he just.
Joyzy.
I need to guess.
Joyzy. You don't have to say new.
Whatever.
Just say Joyzy.
Joyzy.
There you go.
Joyzy. He's Joyzy boy.
Joyzy.
He's Joyzy boy.
Great.
This portion of Animal Radio is brought to you by Cats on Deck. They make cat containment. Now, we've all heard about all kinds of cat containment. I mean, really, that's the easy part.
Mm-hmm.
But Cats on Deck, they provide cat lifestyle enrichment while keeping your cat safe and contained in all kinds of weather.
Very important.
They have a lot of different styles. Plus, you can customize your own style. They are easy to assemble enclosures. Find out more at catsondeck.com. Now, listen up. If you put the promo code ANIMAL in before you check out, you'll get 10% off. Just because you heard this right here. Cats on Deck. And here is your cat tip of the week.
Hi, this is CatsOnDeck.com, sponsoring this cat tip of the week if you're about to have kittens. Kittens are born blind. Eyes begin to open within 5 to 10 days, and fully in another 2 or 3. Weaning can begin when kittens have a sense of balance. Once fully weaned, kittens need to have their vaccinations. Your vet can advise you when it's time. Kittens should not be adopted out until they are at least 12 weeks old. They should be litter box trained, dewormed, partially or fully vaccinated, and of course, it is the owner's responsibility to ensure that the kittens are going to a good home where they will be loved and cared for. If you cannot find any adopters, contact local pet rescue groups who may be able to help find them a home. And since most rescue groups are overcrowded with pets, they will be most likely willing to help if you keep them while they search for a loving home. Kittens are much easier to adopt than adult cats. Visit catsondeck.com, where cat environmental enrichment and safety is a major component of all our cat enclosures.
Imagine a unique cat containment system for your home, apartment, or condo that's incredibly strong, lightweight, and easy to assemble.
Cats on Deck has the answer. With their exclusive InstaClamp, you can quickly change configuration or size by connecting screened panels to each other in minutes. Cats are vertical creatures. With Cats on Deck, you can add shelves, ramps, tunnels, and even a loft. Visit catsondeck.com today, home of modular, lightweight, and strong enclosures, providing superior lifestyle enrichment and a safe outdoor environment for your cat.
This is an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Now there's a healthy and natural solution to prevent oral disease in your pet with no brushing required.
I'm Stacey Cohen for Animal Radio. Well, Americans spent a lot of money on their pets last year, $50.96 billion in 2011. That's an all-time high and the first time in history that more than $50 billion has gone to the dogs, cats, canaries, guppies, and the like, according to the American Pet Products Association in a new report. Food and vet costs accounted for about 65% of the spending, but it was a service category, one that included grooming, boarding, pet hotels, pet sitting, and daycare that grew more than any other. That went from $3.51 billion in 2010 to $3.79 billion in 2011. Well, man's best friend is getting an upgrade. Pets can have positive effects on the owner's emotions. That's how the logic goes. So would a robot pet be able to do the same? There's a robo-bunny that was developed at the University of British Columbia, and it can mediate its users' emotions, calming them down or cheering them up, just by leading them through some deep breathing exercises. For example, the robo-bunny also has a pulse, and it can stiffen or relax its ears. But for now, users of the robo-bunny need to be wired up to biometric sensors for the rabbit to actually sense the user's emotional state and react. This was developed by graduate student Anna Flagg. The sensor, right now just a square blob, it's a few inches long, vaguely reminiscent of a furry Star Trek tribble, can tell the difference between a pet, a scratch, even a breath, and ultimately will recognize up to 30 gestures. The end goal of this would be to try to infer a person's emotional state given how they're touching the fur. Flagg said, imagine a cat that instead of biting you when you scratch it too hard, rolls over and purrs. The one thing a robot can do that's different from an animal is truly be in the service of its owner and do what the owner needs it to do. I don't know, but can't lick you when you want it to. That's one thing. Or can't snore next to you like a human being. I mean, my dog, gosh, I couldn't replace that with a robot. No way. Our pets, when they're with us, see, this is what I mean. We often think of them as our companions, our best friends, even family. When they die, it's very painful. Well, now that emotional connection between the owner and the pet has many animal lovers turning to a growing trend, but not without controversy, freeze drying them. We're talking about freeze drying your pet. This guy thought of a way to say goodbye to his little chihuahua. It had died in his arms. So he went to a taxidermy shop, and it specialized in freeze-dry technology. It's used to preserve animals and wildlife. Anthony Eddy's Wildlife Studio in Slater, Missouri. Pet preservation's become a big part of our business, said the owner, Anthony Eddy. People say they just can't stand to bury or have their pet cremated. Once they find out that there are other ways to deal with a loved one, this is an alternative. The pets are posed, frozen forever and in time. Pet owners are willing to spend thousands of dollars to have a lifelike representation of their animal in their homes. I'm Stacey Cohen. Get more animal breaking news at Animal Radio.
This has been an Animal Radio News Update brought to you by Pets Life Oral Care. Our pets can show signs of oral disease by age 3. Pets Life is the healthy and natural solution with no brushing required. Visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com. Did you know that 80% of dogs show signs of oral disease by age 3 and the cost to fix these issues can be up to $1,000? Now there's a healthy, natural, and affordable solution, and no brushing is required. Pets Life Oral Care breaks down the plaque and tartar that leads to gum disease and bad breath. To avoid those large vet bills and keep your pet healthy, call 888-453-4682. That's 888-453-4682. Or visit PetsLife.com. That's Pets with a Z.com.
What dog food is specifically designed to reduce the risk of cancer, settle digestive upsets, reduce scratching and shedding? Canine caviar. What dog food reduces red tear stains and hot spots? Canine caviar. What dog food has probiotics that reduce the chance of soft stools and have a higher calorie count for better nutrient absorption? Canine caviar. So what are you feeding your dog? If you didn't answer canine caviar, visit caninecaviar.com today and get your pet started on a longer, healthier life.
866-405-8405. It's Animal Radio, celebrating our connection with our pets, as we do every weekend, and continuing with the season of stars, which has been phenomenal thus far, including Betty White, Billy Dean, Margaret Cho, Elaine Boozler, Frankie Avalon, Davy Jones, before he passed that interview. I'm still getting letters about that, by the way.
Oh, I know. That's so sad.
And coming up, we have Lyle Lovett, Kevin Costner. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. What were you saying?
Just saying, yeah, that was sad.
Prince Lorenzo Borghese. Am I pronouncing it right, Joey?
Borghese, yes.
Borghese.
That's right.
Will be joining us in just a few weeks, as well as Doug Gray from the Marshall Tucker Band. Yes, sir.
Do you think we can get some, some discounted cosmetics from him? You know, they make great cosmetics, Borghese. You know, not just for dogs, for people too.
Yeah, a whole pet line.
I'll check on that.
Listen, and we're going to continue today with Dancing with the Stars judge Carrie Ann Inaba. Carrie Ann, welcome to the show. How are you doing?
Hi. Thanks for having me. How are you doing?
Splendid. Now, I understand that you're going to be taking time from the 14th season. I can't believe this is the 14th season.
I know. I can't believe it either. But we do two a year, so it's only been 7 years.
Okay. You're going to be hosting the Genesis Awards. Is that correct?
Yes, I am. I'm so honored that they asked me to host it this year. I attended a few years back, and I was so impressed with the whole awards, and I mean, it's a tearjerker, that awards. It's pretty impressive.
There's some amazing nominations for this year, including some feature films like Dolphin Tale and War Horse,
Rise of the Planet Apes in Rio. Yeah, really fantastic feature films.
What's your favorite nomination thus far?
You know, I love Dolphin Tale, but I might have to go with Rise of the Planet of the Apes.
Really?
Did you see it?
No, I haven't seen
it.
Okay,
I have to say, I know you guys love animals. You'll love it. You'll love it. I don't want to give it away.
Here's my problem, and maybe you can put it to rest. My problem was that I loved the original Planet of the Apes. I was a big fan for
the
original
TV series?
Yes.
Yes.
So when I thought about a movie coming out, I thought that might actually ruin my whole, you know, perception of it. What do you think? Did it?
No, because it sort of takes it into a new dimension. It takes it sort of into the future. And so you immediately let go of what the Planet of the Apes, the television show, was, I thought.
Okay, I'll put it on my list.
Yes, please do. So, yeah, it's one of the 58 nominees for the 26th Annual Genesis Awards, which we're excited about.
They keep getting better and better, by the way. They're including a lot of local news features and talk shows.
Yeah, you know, because I don't know if people know this, but the Humane Society of the United States puts on the Genesis Awards, and it's different than other award shows because what it does is it highlights features or interviews or segments on TV shows that showcase animal protection messages, and it rewards people who inspire people to be aware of this and to do good out there for the animals.
Next year, we're hoping for radio. They're going to add radio, right?
I don't see radio.
Well, you know what? I will put the good word in for radio.
Please. I see more and more categories being added and more nominees, so let's get the radio one in there.
Yeah, you know what? You're right. There's 58 nominees, so I think we can squeeze radio in. I will definitely talk to the people and see if we can get radio in. That would be great.
Tell us about the animals at home.
Oh, I have six animals. I have six cats and two new puppies.
What kind?
Wow.
They're not really puppies, although I call them puppies. One is, they're obviously both rescues. One who's staring at me right now, we just got her yesterday, and her name is Peanut. You know, we're trying to figure out what she is, but she's 2 years old, and she's all black, and she's a Chihuahua pug terrier mix.
Wow.
You know, I had one of those, and I couldn't figure it out, so I had a DNA test done.
Oh, is that possible?
It is. They draw the blood, and then they can check the DNA in the database, and they can tell you what mixtures are in there.
I would love to know that.
You need to do that.
We need to get her hooked up with the people that did it for us.
Please do. Thank you so much. And, you know, I adopted her because they say that black animals are really hard to get adopted out because, like, in pictures and videos, they don't show well.
Right.
So the rescue groups really try to push for the little puppies. And I had featured her, this one, on Access Hollywood Live when I did Billy Bush's show the other day. And I thought, oh, she's so cute, and if she doesn't get adopted, call me, because I kind of felt the connection. Sure enough, I got a call a week later, and I was like, really? And she said, yeah. And I brought her home yesterday, and we were going to introduce her to our other dog, who is, her name is Cookie, and she's a boxer who's 8 years old with terrible arthritis, who's also a rescue.
Aww.
But we thought we were going to introduce her to Cookie first, but instead, she fell in love with the cat. So we're really excited, because, you know, we have six cats. I'm more of a cat person than I was a dog person, but obviously, I'm both.
Well, you had a cat that lived 19 years?
Yes, my cat Shadow lived 19 years. He was such an amazing cat.
That's a great long life.
Wow.
And he's one of those that I'm sure you guys can relate, that he chose me. He walked in my front door one day and never left. And you know, the ones that choose you, you have that extra special like connection to. And in a way, I guess they all choose you because they sort of reach into your heart and pull on those strings. But that one definitely walked in my door, and I think he saved me more than I saved him.
I got a great Dancing with the Stars story with a dog.
Oh, tell me.
And I just want to let you know, it's not just for people, because my sister-in-law is a 128-pound Rottweiler. And only when your show comes on, the dog watches the whole show and will walk around the table with a toy in his mouth, and when the commercial breaks come on, he will lay down. And then when you come back on, he'll walk around the table and won't stop and just watches the television the whole time. Only for Dancing with the Stars.
That's wonderful.
I swear, God, strike me dead if I'm not telling the truth here.
Oh, who knew that our show had the mass appeal to the dogs out there? That's wonderful.
Well, you know, we've noticed that there are a lot of animal lovers that get involved with Dancing with the Stars. We just had Margaret Cho on for our Season of the Stars, and she was a contestant. And she said she actually practiced with her dog for that.
And then we also had Joanna Krupa, who you know is also an animal lover.
It is a good thing. We've had John O'Hurley on. He won the first season?
Oh, that was way back, yes.
Yeah. You know, it's interesting because I find that the animal-loving community, because I've been doing a lot of rescue, and, you know, I do, and you guys know about the email chains that go around that to help dogs that are maybe going to be euthanized the next day, and it's about raising funds for them and maybe going out and getting them transport to wherever they need to go, whether it's to shelter or to a foster or to a home. And I have found that the people I meet in the animal-loving community are probably my favorite people I've met out of any community that I've met.
I have to agree.
Yeah. Oh, you agree? They just all have those big, warm, open hearts, and I'm just, it's, I don't know, I finally feel like I've found my community that I'm sticking with.
Damn straight.
Yeah.
That's not all you're doing. You're doing a new web show now for cats?
Huh? Yes, I am. I'm producing a show called Crib Cats on Petsami.com, or Petsami, we say Petsami, and it's basically a little show hosted by a cat, who's a cat actress. Her name is Kit, and she's basically a matchmaker. And we have her living in this cool crib, and a crib in cat speak is a forever home, a forever loving home.
Uh-huh.
So what she does is she showcases cats from various shelters, no-kill shelters.
You are staying so busy with the animals. We love it.
I am, and I feel really good about it. It's made my life feel, I don't know, I feel complete now. It's nice.
Well, we thank you so much for joining us today and telling us about what's going on in your world and, of course, about the Genesis Award. And we'll put links over at the website at animalradio.com.
Yeah, I hope we'll see some people in the audience.
You are so awesome.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks. Have a great day.
All right, thanks. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye now.
Animal Radio is brought to you by Natural Balance Pet Food, the finest food you can buy for the health of your pet. No matter which line of Natural Balance Pet Food you choose, you know it will truly be the food for a lifetime. Visit www.naturalbalance.net to learn more.
Attention, diabetics covered by Medicare.
Call now and you can be one of the first customers to receive a new pain-free talking meter at little or no cost to you. 800-917-2411, 800-917-2411. These new meters are more accurate, easier to use, and are pain-free, so you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Even better, if you're one of the first 100 callers that qualifies, you'll receive a free Betty Crocker Living with Diabetes cookbook. 800-917-2411. 800-917-2411. That's right. If you're a diabetic and you have Medicare, you may qualify to receive a new talking meter and a free Betty Crocker cookbook with your first order. But hurry, supplies are limited, so call right now. 800-917-2411. 800-917-2411.
My friend, it's Animal Radio, celebrating our connection with our pets. Toll free, 1-866-405-8405. And I got to say, it seems like there's a little more room in the studio, and it may be because, Joey Villani, you are doing really good on your diet. How much have you lost?
39 pounds as of this morning.
Whoa. Congratulations.
Wow. Yeah. Where is it all going?
5 pounds of it went this way.
Oh. Hi, Bob. Welcome to Animal Radio.
How you doing?
Very good. I have Dr. Debbie right here for you.
Well, hi, Bob.
Okay. Hi, how you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. What kind of critter you got? Furry, feathered, slithering?
It's furry. It's a 3-year-old golden retriever.
What's going on?
Well, he was getting these, I don't know if you know what they are. They're called, they're like little spurs, foxtails.
Okay.
He was getting them between his toes. So my son took the trimmers and trimmed the hair between his toes. We trimmed one of them too short, and it nicked it and got a sore on there.
Okay.
And he kept licking it, and it kept wasn't getting any better. So my wife's been soaking it and putting stuff on it, and it's gotten better. But then it got a big blister on it. My son popped the blister. I guess some bloody clear liquid came out, but it hadn't come back. But we wondered if there's anything else that we can do for it, or if that's the best stuff we're doing, what we're doing.
Yeah, with what you're describing here, Bob, I think there's two things that I might look at with him. Number one is that in many cases, these foxtails, they burrow in, and part of it is kind of above the surface, and the other part is like an iceberg. It's underneath the water, underneath the skin surface. So it's very possible he could still have some of that embedded in there, and that's just going to fester until we can get that surgically yanked out of there. And I'm always impressed by the ability of foxtail, these little seed parts, to just kind of working their way into the body and really just kind of putting their arms up against the door jamb and saying, I'm not going anywhere. So really, I'd have to encourage you to get that looked at to see if we need to do a little minor surgery on that to get that out.
Yeah.
The second thing that's really important when we get these kind of festering sores is soaking is great, but he's probably going to need some antibiotics. Once we break down that skin barrier and you've got an open sore, it's just standard of care for these kind of things to get the baby on some antibiotics to help that heal from the inside out. And I think with those two things, then you'll have a chance of getting things to heal up. But, they can really be buggers and, even just other areas of the feet. So if you haven't, I'm sure you've already looked around, but common places this past week and this past month, my gosh, we've had them out of dogs' eyeballs.
Wow.
We've had them come out of vaginal areas of dogs. Yesterday I took one out of a prepuce of a dog. Believe it or not, it migrated through. Horrible stuff.
My daughter's dog swallowed one. Had to go to the vet and put her,
yes,
put her under to get it out.
Absolutely, that will migrate through the digestive tract and basically kind of cause abdominal peritonitis, basically. So yeah, some bad stuff. So I do a nose to tail search, really, from inside the ears, inside the oral cavity, all the feet, lift the tail, look at all the private parts, and those are really the places where these foxtails like to live and just kind of fester. So I'd definitely get your little fella over to the vet and see if we need to go poking around in that that sore a little bit.
All right, well, I appreciate it.
Thanks for your call today, Bob. Yes, antibiotics, very important with that. 1-866-405-8405 to talk to Dr. Debbie or groomer Joey Volani, animal communicator Joy Turn, or Vladi, the world famous Russian dog wizard right now. It's toll free.
You're listening to Animal Radio. You can learn more at animalradio.com. Log on, learn more.
Animal Radio. Our season of stars continues with Dr. Joyce Brothers. Eddie Money will be on in a few weeks. Kevin Costner, who's a musician and is going on tour.
Ooh.
Yeah, the same actor. He's actually plays.
That's big.
I don't know what instrument he plays, but we'll find out. Also, some kind of prince we're having on. Is this prince like the
Lorenzo
singer?
No.
He's Prince Lorenzo Borghese?
Yeah, I think that's the way you pronounce it.
Has anyone heard of this guy?
He makes pet products.
Yes, he does. He has a royal pet line.
And
he's
he does.
He helps raise money for the animal causes. He just did some for the city of New York, and he's a big animal lover.
Also, and if you're like me, you like the old-time music there, Marshall Tucker Band, you remember them? The singer will be joining us. And I'm looking at Judy because she knows I'm going to ask the name.
Doug.
Gray? Is it Doug Gray?
Yes,
Doug Gray. The singer of the Marshall Tucker Band will be joining us for the Season of Stars, all coming up within the next few weeks. We got to get all their names pronounced right before they come on the air, right? Let's see. We have a call for Ernie Rodina, our horse expert, and is it Judy? It's Judy.
Yeah, another Judy.
Welcome to the show, Judy.
Hi, thank you.
What's going on?
Well, I have a question.
This is a that's
it's a good start.
Now, if you were ordering a pizza, this would probably be the wrong place. But you have a horse question, I assume.
I do. Well, it's basically a rodeo question. I'm just wondering how Ernie feels about rodeo, if he thinks that there's animal cruelty involved.
Great question. The question coming from Judy is, do I think there's animal cruelty involved in rodeos? And I could not believe any stronger that there's that these stock contractors, if anybody ever had a chance to be around them and be one of them, they take care of their stock. They take pride in their stock and treat them the very best. And that's my take on it.
And Ernie, you know, I've actually talked to some animals that have been in rodeos. They actually, most of them, don't mind being there. Some of them actually enjoy it. They love being kind
exactly.
of like an icon.
Exactly. And, you know, the really good ones, you hit the nail on the head, the really good ones enjoy their job. But I have to say, I see how these stock contractors take care of their stock, and that's their livelihood.
Yes.
And so they take care of them very well.
It just seems to me that, I don't know, feels a little bit brutal at times. I wonder how a calf can enjoy getting roped and thrown to the ground myself, but I can understand the bucking part, maybe.
Animals will do amazing things to help out. Humans come to different levels of awareness and understanding, and that's part of what they're doing here with the rodeo.
Okay.
And I would say on the rodeo also that if there is anybody abusing them, their own folks get on them and penalize them. You know, I just have to say it's been around a long time, and I just know stockmen. I work with stockmen, and I know how they take care of them, and I think they take the very best care of them.
Now, I got to say, I side a little bit with Judy. I kind of feel, you know, I've always thought circuses and rodeos are two events that the animals may not be 100% with.
Well, they don't have a choice to participate.
They don't have the, and you know,
they're just thrown in there.
By the way, that brings up something I just saw in the news this week. It really upsets me. Bob Barker, who's been a big advocate for the animals. He got some elephants out of Alaska.
An elephant, yes.
He wants to put an end to the performing animals, the
traveling animals that do circuses across the country.
He just gave a $2 million donation to PETA, which I think is probably one of the worst organizations in the world. He was my best bud.
And
now,
man,
I got to tell you, this really irks me.
$2.5
million to PETA.
To let them have a building in L.A. so they could have West Coast headquarters.
And this is the organization that we all think is doing great for animals, but their euthanization rate is 95% at their shelters.
They don't even really have a shelter.
I want to say something, though.
Yeah.
You mentioned circuses. Because I used to work in arenas all the time, we used to do Ringling Brothers all of the time. Now, my big thing is I don't like the animals chained up or caged. I mean, that's the part that bothers me. But as far as, you know, them being taken care of, I have to tell you, I mean, those animals were very well taken care of. And I've never seen abuse. And they've spent weeks in my building at a time. And, you know, I did it for over 25 years, before I came out here to California. So,
sure.
And matter of fact, I was out there 2 weeks ago and they had the circus there. And they actually had kitty cats, believe it or not, doing backflips. But that's besides the point. But I had to throw that in there because it would just amaze me.
I had the opportunity to be with a guy by the name of Jimmy Crothers, one of the top rodeo contractors around. And he's not an animal communicator, Joy, but, you know, he'd say, well, that bull likes what he's doing. You can see that bull enjoys itself. So these guys take a lot of passion in their animals.
Well, you got to figure that this is their livelihood. This is their bread and butter, and they certainly can't be abusing animals. So, you know, I'm sitting on the fence there. Judy, I hear what you're saying. Thanks so much for calling today.
Thank you.
Wow, it seems like it just flew by today.
That's plenty.
Okay.
Yeah,
it was a big
day.
Yeah, it's been a long day.
Thank you so much for joining us. Let me remind you, our phone lines are open all week long at 1-866-405-8405. Leave us a voicemail message. Hey, we might even pick it up. Or visit us over at Facebook. Yeah, I didn't think this thing would catch on, but apparently Facebook is the thing for these kids these days.
Go figure.
Animal Radio is our Facebook page. You can ask us your questions there. And if you like us over there,
Every single day this week, we are giving away a prize package for you and your pet, valued at trillions of dollars. I don't know how much it's valued at, but it's definitely a prize package that you want, simply for liking us at Facebook. Also, catch us, get your tweets, get all tweeted out. This is another thing I didn't think we'd catch on. Twitter. Animal Radio is our Twitter address. And if you sign up and subscribe to be an Animal Radio tweet receiver, you'll get all the important news, including recalls. We had a couple of recalls this last week, and the first thing when we get those, we tweet them so that you know. Want to thank NASCAR driver Cory Joyce, as well as Dancing with the Stars judge Carrie Ann Inaba. She didn't like my suggestion about changing her name. That's too bad. We'll catch you back here next week for more Animal Radio on this awesome station.
Bye.
Have a great week.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, everybody.
Back to you next time, guys.
Bye.
This is Animal Radio Network.